Meanwhile, the DeSaulnier family is also getting closer to their moment of truth. The Grabbit spot has now been edited, and Yvonne and sons Donald and David get their first look at the spot.
I like this this shot. That's a good shot.
Simply drill out the damaged area with the patented cutting end and flip the tool around, and the extracting end gets it right out.
I think they could do better on that.
Coming up, the moment of truth for the passionate people behind two great products.
I mean, the results are what they are. I can't change them.
For the DeSaulnier family, a lot is riding on a small product called the Grabbit.
I think they could do better on that.
After a disappointing rough cut, the Grabbit commercial has been reshot, re-edited, tweaked, and ultimately approved. The Grabbit has also attracted the attention of as-seen-on-TV giant Telebrands. Now it's time to hear from Telebrand CEO A.J. Kubani, who has rolled out a test marketing campaign across several territories. A.J. will let the family know if Billy's pitch is a hit or a miss.
Hello, A.J., this is Donald DeSaulnier from Alden Corporation.
Hi, Donald. How are you?
Good. How are you, A.J.?
Good, thanks.
Also, our Vice President of Accounting, Dennis DeSaulnier, is also with us.
How are you doing, A.J.?
Very good. Well, that commercial was finally finished, and we went ahead and tested it. And so far, the results look quite poor. We should discontinue running this particular advertisement. I'm confident that with our experience, we can make this commercial work. I think there's definitely a way to make this profitable. The product is a terrific product, has a lot of scope. There's a big demand for the product out there, and we just need to get the right creative. We'll make sure we keep you in the loop.
Okay, great.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, AJ.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Okay, bye. Nice talking to you. Yeah, thanks. Keep in mind, Donald, that the economy plays a big part of this. $20 in today's world, it's still a lot of money when you don't have it. You know, people don't have disposable income right now.
The disappointing news has a bright side for the Grabbit team. When Telebrands committed to the project, they agreed to put up all the money for the marketing campaign in exchange for a share of the profits. Now, Yvonne and Sons will sit back and see if Telebrands can right the ship.
I'm glad that AJ feels they can make it work, because I think it'll work and it'll be good for both of us.
Glad to hear that. That's good news.
Now it's time to learn the fate of the Tool Bandit. Mike Sherm has his future riding on this. Billy and Sully gather the data on how well the ad's done. They'll analyze how much money came in on a range of networks at different times of day. This data will be enough to tell whether Mike is a great American success story or if he's going back to his day job.
It's do or die. I mean, the results are what they are. I can't change them. You know, this is really the, you know, culmination of it all. I'm very excited about it, but at the same time, I'm trying to stay balanced and not get ahead of myself.
There he is.
How are you?
See you. Hey, great. How about yourself?
Good to see you.
Take a seat.
Tool Bandito.
So actually, we do have some news for you. We just got off the phone, actually, with the media buyer, and we've been on the phone with Nancy and John.
Tool Bandit is a grand slam.
Right on.
Home run, buddy.
Liking it.
Really is.
Awesome.
There's no doubt in my mind.
And I gotta be honest, I wasn't as keen as he was, but he knew from the very beginning. It was almost like he had a premonition, and congratulations, man. It doesn't happen very often. Soak it up.
That's good.
It all turned out the way it's supposed to. The hard work paid off, and I am so happy. This is like a dream. It's awesome. It feels good. I'm going to relish the moment, but you know, I'm going to have to come back down to earth here pretty quickly and get ready for the wild ride that's coming up.
The Tool Bandit has struck a chord with the public. The test campaign was aimed at networks that attract a lot of do-it-yourselfers, and the ad brought in 3.5 times the cost of airtime. A full ad campaign is being planned, And estimates are that Mike and his partners could gross up to $700,000 a week on Tool Bandit. On the other hand, the Grab-It still hasn't found its groove as a TV product, but it has sold exceptionally well through major stores. It's been a long, hard road, but the DeSaulniers' investment appears to be paying off.